And let's turn our attention back to the hand of the pastor.
All right. Listen, again, on behalf of the family, thank you for coming to the final resting place of Henry's body. As I said earlier, what we believe the Scripture teaches is that though we're absent from the body, we're present with the Lord. So let's don't mistake that. Henry's with the Lord. But his body is left here. And his body is going to be laid in the ground in just a moment. And I want you to also understand that what we do in a moment like this is a very Christian thing. What I mean by that is, as Christians, what we believe is we put this body in its full capacity in the ground, believing that Jesus tells us he'll one day come back and the dead in Christ will rise first. And so with that belief, we're doing this. It may look crazy to the world, and it does often. The reality is we do this because we believe that the Lord Jesus is going to come back one day, and these bodies will be raised to new bodies. And so we'll be in heaven, in the new heavens and the new earth. In case you're wondering, we'll have bodies. We'll have spirits, but we'll have bodies. There'll be new bodies, right? Aren't you glad of that? I'm glad of that. I'm glad this old body here that's falling apart, decaying, isn't going to live forever like this. Jesus will make it a new body. And so what we're doing is an act of faith that's very Christian in that manner. But we gather here today not only to commit this body to the ground, but to give a word, if I can, real briefly, to this sweet family. Psalm 23 says this, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. He restores my soul. He guides me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. And even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You have anointed my head with oil. My cup overflows. Surely goodness and loving kindness will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Real briefly, David wrote this psalm, 23rd Psalm, as many of you may be familiar with that. He wrote it about a shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. 17 different times in this psalm, David refers in the personal pronoun, either I or mine. Now that's contrary to most of the Old Testament. Most of the Old Testament is written about the people's God, Israel's God, right? Our God. And there's nothing wrong with that. But David shifts the mindset and he says, God is our God. God is the God of all things. But here's what David says. It's one thing for God to be our God. It's quite a different thing to understand God is my God. David wants us to know, especially in a moment like this, when we walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that our good shepherd is a personal good shepherd. You know why I say that, family? Because the truth of the matter is, I've been here, I buried my mom. We've all been here before with someone we love. But no one completely understands what you're feeling right now. And the reason I say it is because each of you have an emotion that goes with your relationship with Henry. And though you're siblings, though we're friends, the reality of it is, your relationship and my relationship is so personal with Henry that no one can feel your shoes. No one can fully understand what you're thinking right now. No one can do that. But you know how personal God is? He can do that. He knows what you're feeling. He knows the questions you have. He knows why you're asking the questions why. He knows that. And so it's one thing for me to say to you, our God is big enough to take care of us, and he is. But it's quite a different thing for you to understand your God is big enough and small enough, in a sense, to be so personal and to draw near to you and to feel everything you're feeling and to know how to minister to your heart. When no one else understands, our God's personal enough to understand. In a moment like that, that's what I want to know. In a moment just like this, I want to know he's going to draw near to me. The Bible says he'll draw near to us if we draw near to him. I encourage you to keep drawing near to him in moments like this. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. I want to pray for us. We'll commit this body and I'll step aside. Hey, Father, as I gather this with this family, I thank you for your spirit that ministers to each and every one of us. It ministers to us as a group, but it oftentimes ministers to us on a personal level. I pray that this family would know the personal touch of the Lord Jesus in this moment, that you would speak to their hearts, and when no one else understands what they're thinking or what they're feeling, God, may they know you do. David gave us a clear picture of how personal you are. He said, you're not just our shepherd, though you are. You are his shepherd. You're my shepherd. And as they cling to their shepherd, Lord, I pray that you would cling to them. Wrap your arms around them and love them like only you can. And Father, this time we do come to commit this body to the ground. We do so as an act of faith, believing that one day you will return and the dead in Christ will rise first. Paul tells us to be encouraged and comforted by those words. And as we look forward to that day, Lord Jesus, we give you thanks. But in the meantime, between now and then, between now when we're separated and then when we're reunited, in that meantime, I pray that you would minister to this family and to each of our hearts in a very special way. We love you, and we ask you, Lord, to bless this dear family. In Jesus' name I pray.
This time we'd like to thank Pastor Brian, Pastor Sam, Pastor Ed back there in the back, any other men and women of the gospel for all your acts of kindness that you have shown them during this day of our the blog that you hold in your hand, you can keep it in remembrance of Mr. Stephen that you may deposit it unto the casket. Soon after we reload the family, we would carry them out to the American Legion Post 558 for the repair. After being greeted by the ministry, we asked each other, let us reload the family, get them out of this heat. We will ask that his nephew do come for the help us carry Mr. Stephen to his final rest. Six of his nephews. Six means.